All right, so New Year is gearing up, and I am now getting my hard drive set up so that I can have redundant backups for my work drive. This is an absolutely critical thing you need to do if you are working professionally in any capacity, because you don't want to be in a situation where you have a drive that goes down, because they will go down, and then you have to go to a client and tell them that their project has disappeared. It's always, always, always critical to have a good backup. Now, there's lots of good options on the clouds, RAIDs, all that stuff. I want to show you something that I found that was actually really, really affordable and really, really easy to do, and it's called ChronoSync. So let's go ahead and take a look and see how this works. Now, as you can see here on my computer, I have two drives right here that I've labeled 2023 work one and 2023 work two. Now, the key is I want these two drives to be mirrored. I want them to literally be identical. And the main thing is I never want to have to think about backing up this drive. I want to do it automatically. And this is where ChronoSync really comes in and is an absolute lifesaver. Now, what I do is I open up ChronoSync, and I've been using this now for years and I've never had a problem with it. It's just an absolutely fantastic app. I'm going to create a new synchronizer task. So to ask me what I want to call this, I'm going to call this 2023 backups, work backups. Make it nice and clean. I know exactly what that is. And now that I've created this, I want to do a left to right backup. And literally, it's very, very intuitive. Whatever hits here on the left is going to back up over here to the right. And now, the main thing I want to do is I want to make sure that I mirror it. So I want to mirror left to right. Because remember, I'm trying to create a hard drive that is identical to the one before. Now, once I know that, I need to choose what I'm driving. So I'm going to come here. I'm going to go to my computer. I'm going to choose 2023 work one as the one on the left. And then I want to make sure that 2023 work two here is the one on the right. And now you can see it's mirrored left to right. So everything here on the left is going to mirror over here onto the right. Now, there's another very, very important thing to do. I want to make sure if you're working in any kind of professional capacity, you're working with clients, you're inevitably going to be deleting stuff as well as adding stuff. If you want to save yourself a headache, make sure that deletions come across as well. Now, this is very, very important to save you from dealing with a massive headache mess. So what I want to do is make sure that I sit there and I write synchronize deletions. This is very, very important. Now, the good news is if you do choose this, you have some options if you are kind of cagey and worried about it. The first thing you can do is you can actually delete immediately. That means if you make a deletion on one drive, it's going to automatically go on the other one. The other thing you can do is you can move it to trash. This is kind of a nice intermediate. This means that it's going to take those deleted files, keep them in the trash can, but it's not deleted until you come back later and do that. And if you're really, really cagey, you can go to move to archives. What it does is creates another folder on your drive called archives and just gives you kind of a backup of your backups. Something if you want to do, if you're really, really worried, have really mission critical data that you may have to come back and get for some reason, maybe you want that peace of mind, it's there to go. I usually do delete immediately, but what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go move to archive on this just to show you have that option. And that's most of the way there. It's really this simple. Now, one of the things I think is really important too, make sure you come over into the options menu, because there are going to be certain programs like Final Cut is a great example that actually nest information inside a folder. So you need to make sure that when you're backing up that nested information as well. So come here to basic and go to custom. And go ahead and cut off smart scan. And what you want to do is for package handling, go to dissect. This will basically go inside those folders and make sure that all your information is getting uploaded inside folders like in Final Cut and other programs like that. And then basically that is going to be what I have to do to get this thing set up. Now, that I've got this set up, you can have this set up in a lot of ways. The first thing is now that it's there, I can literally just come and play this out. But to make this make sense, you need to have it timed. So what you want to do is you need to come and go ahead and put add to schedule. Now you get a couple options here. Now you can do hourly backups if you're really, really worried about it. This is something that does not make any sense for me because I'm going to be using these files. I'll be working off these files and you have to be careful because if you're in a situation, let's say you're working on a Premiere file and you're editing and this thing's updating every hour, it's just going to lead to all kinds of messes. You could potentially corrupt data. I would not recommend that unless you're using this purely as like a data file. But if you're working on these drives, I would not recommend it. What I do recommend is you can go ahead What I do is I like to put it on daily. And what I make sure is I always back up my hard drive. Sometime I go to bed, I make sure it backs up that night. Every day I know the information's backed up. Worst case scenario, I will lose 8 days of work. I wouldn't lose months of work. I certainly won't lose all my clients' work. And usually what I like to do is I'm going to go ahead and say I'm usually puttering off about 12:15 a.m. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to say 12:30 just to be extra safe. So every day at 12:30, now this will start a backup and I never have to think about it ever again. I literally hit add and then boom, it is literally that done. So there you go, really is that simple. I know now every night at 12:30 that all of the work that I've worked on that day is being backed up perfectly and I never have to worry about this. I've used this program for years and it has saved my life more than once. And the good news is it's really cheap. If you look here, it's only $50 for the program. As a matter of fact, there's a sale right now that you can buy it for $39. So for $40, you can get this. So for $50, in my opinion, this is something that is absolutely so critical in how I work. I can't imagine actually working it without it after having used it for the last couple of years. And the other good news about this, honestly, it's not a subscription service. You pay one time, you have it, and then you can use it for years knowing you've got your stuff backed up nice and safe. Anyway, guys, I thought you might find that kind of useful. Go out there, keep on shooting, and yeah, I'll talk to you soon.